Well, I thought I'd show you a video of my Myrmecerna's Bing Hammy. The majority of the colony is in this cardboard, which I've put in this test tube here. And there's a crevice there. There's around 20 workers in that little crevice here. There's eggs here for some reason. I guess it's just the most humid part of the test tube. There are springtails dotted around this test tube here, as this species eats springtails. So there are 3 eggs there, so indication the queen is probably just chilling out around here in this bit of the test tube. It's like a little den kind of thing. If you know what I mean, like they would go in there, and then boom, that's where most of them hang out. I don't know if I'll be able to get a proper look inside. Probably not, but I can see a worker or two in there at the current moment. Yeah, I can see them all hanging out in there. Which is good for them, because I don't think they like getting disturbed too much. That's alright, but they've got soil and things, so their eggs can spin, I mean their larvae can spin cocoons. In my opinion, these look like trap jaws, but I think they also look like Myrmecia to an extent with the jaws. Now, if I can get a proper thing without the light glare, I'll show you what I mean. Look, there we go, okay. Right, so you can see that work on the top left, yeah? The mouth parts are wide. They've got some wide mouths, I'll tell you that. When they set their spring traps for their mouths. I'll see if one of the actual workers here does it, but I don't think it will. I've seen them catch a few springtails, funnily enough, but they mainly just kind of spit them out and then pick them up again, so to speak, sort of thing. There's one there. I don't know if it's going to try and hunt a springtail. Look, there's one there. Coming out the nest to say hello. Let's see if we can... Oh, they've got extraordinary vision, believe it or not. My opinion, they do have extraordinary vision, and they do. It says they do. In the papers that I've read about them. Is that another one coming out to say hello? No, I don't think it is. Actually, it might be. I think there might be just one at the left corner there, because my camera quality is not the best. But it's okay for what we're doing at the moment. This one's hunting springtails, meaning that there must be some sort of larvae there. Let's see if we can get a nice close up of that. Probably not, but because my camera's bad. Did it catch it there? Did it catch it? Let me see. Come on. Please. You know, I need some better recording equipment. I really do. I've also not got the steadiest hands for this sort of thing, but please bear with me. But these ants look quite extraordinary, I must admit. There's one there, trying to get that one. You can see there at the... Come on, focus. See if we can get it. Come on. Nah, it missed. Silly. And now it's skulking off in sadness. Oh, now it's cleaning itself. Maybe it's getting ready for round 2. Oh, there we go. Come on. Show the audience what you can do, Myrmecerna's. Oh, no, I don't think it's interested. This is by far the easiest trap jaws I've ever had to even rear, because I remember Odontomachus, well, they're actually not pottering ants, they're more formicine, it's a convergent evolution or something like that. Just so happens to be a fluke of evolution that they have trap jaws like this. So like Strumogenes, as well. You can see that there, the mouth parts. These also love honey as well, which is funny. That rhymed. So what I do is I feed them springtails, and then I feed them honey water every week or two, so they don't do too bad. I've only had one worker die off, so it's not that bad. They do live for quite a while.